Welcome to the Man Cave. Today we have a little Mobilette engine here, which I'm going to strip, take the cylinder head off it and change the head gasket and the barrel gasket. This has been off the road a hell of a long time. As you've seen my videos before, I've done work on lots of four-stroke engines. I know them quite well. You know, the 4.2 Jag and endless lawnmowers and vintage station engines, I've done quite a few, but this two-stroke, not too gemmed up on two-strokes, so we will see how it goes. But yeah, so I'm now going to start the strip down. I want to take this cover off first, check the points, because this engine hasn't been around for 30 years, and I want to replace the gasket in here and the head gasket. So let me get set up and we will be going. Right, we're back again. So we'll set that there and let's get going. So now we want to get this off. I've got basic hand tools. I will just show you what tools I have. I've got some circlip pliers, some brake cleaner, some duck oil. These are just basic tools really. Socket, I think all I'm going to need is a 10mm, so I think that's all they are in there. This little thing on the top there, if you're wondering, is a decompressor. But yeah, and I've got a small cylinder holding tool as well, if we need it. Let me put the camera back up. And I'm hoping it's getting it. If not, the GoPro was there, that should be getting it. Right, so to start with, I want to get this off. Now that is a 3/8 in there, I believe. So let me get the airline. I don't know whether this is a left-hand thread. Oops, not sure which way it goes. Ah, didn't know whether that's left-hand thread or not. So let's look in this points cover. Wow, I am amazed. I was expecting that to be a total horror in there. It's actually really good. We've even got a decent points gap. We've even got a decent points gap in there. Alright. Going to just get in there and clean these points out a little, and I don't think we're going to have to do a lot much else to this. That's, if this doesn't actually spark, I shall be amazed. That must be the coil if it don't. Alright, we'll just clean the points out. I'll just get some brake cleaner and clean all that out. Brake cleaner is very, very fast evaporating, so it isn't going to do it any damage. Oops, that's the clutch on. So now we've got these out, let's concentrate. I think to start with, don't want to disruptate that wire so that can stay there. Let's just buzz off the, I think we've got a gasket for our inlet manifold. Yes, we have, look. So we can just take this little gasket off. I'm going to put all the bolts in the clutch actually, so I don't lose them. Everything on this moped so far has actually come undone. It hasn't actually been a problem. I've had nothing ring off apart from a couple of fixings for the mudguards. But that's about it. Ah, she's come off nice and easy. And that gasket actually looks superb on there. So whether I'll even change that gasket, I don't know. It looks a lot better gasket than the new one what's come in here. This one, I don't know, we'll see how easy it comes off. Let's see if it will come off. It might. I've never worked on one of these Mobilette engines before, ever. No, it's not. It's going to come off in pieces, which is what I was afraid of. I was afraid of that. No, it isn't. It's all off in one bit. It will just need a little clean. But certainly, there you go. That is actually very good indeed. So let's now get these cylinder head bolts off and hope I haven't missed nothing. I'm pretty sure it's just the four bolts. And the head and the cylinder will come off. I hope. I can't guarantee that, but I hope. This engine hasn't been split in, like I say, years. Absolutely years since this has been split. If it ever has been split, I mean, the moped's a 1973. My dad's had it in his shed since, I think we worked out about 1985 that went in the shed. So it would have been about 12 years old, and the likelihood is, with the mileage this moped has on it, which is about 27,000, I wouldn't have thought the head's ever been off. Oh, this one's a little bit tighter. I bet the whole stud's coming out on this one. Can't guarantee it, but I bet you the whole stud's turning out. No, it isn't. Minute the whole head stud had turned out, but it hasn't. There you go. So let's see now. Go, and here is, wow, that cylinder actually looks surprisingly good. Now I think, it does. This should just come out. It does, there you go, there's our cylinder. And that is remarkably nice condition in there. Just give it some brake cleaner, getting cleaned up a bit. I don't know whether you can see in there, there is no scoring at all. That is, it's a little bit glazed, mind you. So we are going to want to put my little cylinder holder through it just to give it a little scuff up. Even the piston is brilliant. I can't see any problem at all with that piston either. Even the rings are nice and free in the grooves. Yep, can't see any problems here with this at all. There's a little circlip thing there, which is obviously for your piston. Instead of putting a circlip, they put a little white wire clip in here, looking at it. I So now we've got to see if we can actually get the see if we can just get the con rod out, the dodging pin out, sorry. Should have a little. Oh yes, that's coming out. Wherever that just went, that's gone on the floor there somewhere. But we have one removed piston. Let's check what this little end bearing's like. Yeah, that actually looks really good as well. No ply in it. Noise, that's just the compressor. Here is our gudgeon pin. So there's the gudgeon pin. And the bottom half of that engine actually looks to be really good. I just want to clean this out though, just in case any excess oil has got in here over the years. So we'll give him a clean out. And we'll leave that engine upside down for a couple of minutes. There's the cylinder head. All looks quite good as well. Let's just give that a little clean. This is a little brass wire brush. We're just gonna agitate it a bit with a little wire brush. I'm actually remarkably surprised. How clean this cylinder head has come up. I mean, there is just no pitting, no damage to this at all. And also give me a way to see how that decompressor works. Ah, you pull the cable, it just pushes that up. All it is. So let's just give that head a little clean. Get on a flat bit of bench. Here we go. To be honest with you, that didn't really need too much cleaning, that was pretty spotless. Same with the cylinder head surfacing, it's just brilliant. This is only superficial around the outside, but that is nice to have them nice and clean. There's actually some little casting marks on this bottom of this barrel. Right, let's get the honer in there. Let's get the honer in and give the cylinder a little hone. That's given that a nice little hone actually. Go. We have actually given the cylinder some nice little hatching marks now. That's yeah, you can see in there, that's got some lovely little hatching marks. Don't want to overdo it, so I don't want to wear the cylinder out. So we don't give it too much, just a little bit. I want to clean the bottom of these fins off a bit. Like I say, this isn't going to do anything to the way the engine runs, but it'll make me happy now that that's clean in there. Plus we need to get this gasket off. How easy that's going to come off though, I do not know, but it does need to come off. And yes, brake cleaner is superb for everything. Difference between brake and carb cleaner is carb cleaner tends to leave a slightly more oily residue, which is good if you're rebuilding carbs, but obviously not good if you're rebuilding brakes. But I tend to not worry about the oily residue, and I like to have it myself, so I like to do all that myself. Here's a standy blade. I'm just gonna get this gasket off if we can. There it comes. Thin gasket, they don't give you a lot of tolerance on here at all. This is extremely thin. Can't do anything to this gasket, I must admit. Hardly anything to it. This gasket is way for thin, what I've put on here. So to be honest with you, there's very little to get off. Very little gasket to get off. And I'm actually using 180 grit paper here just to sand these off. Pretty good. There we go. Clean all these ports out. Somewhere in here I think there's a little copper gasket in there for the exhaust. There is. And here the little sucker comes. little piston. I'll give him a little clean as well. Cleaning them piston ring grooves as well. Although saying that, these rings are extremely free in this. These rings are extremely free. I mean, there's no bit of expansion in them. They're nice and loose. That one's actually holding place with a little pin to stop that one spinning. Ah, it's a pin to stop both of them spinning. So let's just clean all this out. Not so, I don't want to overdo it, because you don't really want to go and overdo it when you're doing things like pistons. You don't particularly. All you really want to do is take the glaze off them. Only very gently, you don't want to overdo it. Just take the glaze off, take the shine off, and make sure everything's spotless. Yep, which is about right, there's no grit in there. Yeah, I've cleaned that. And we'll just put that there. I think to put this piston back in, I'm going to put the engine in a vise. That's going to be easier if the engine's in a vise. And before I put it back together, because I've brake cleaned it all, I'm going to put a little bit of, yes, this is slightly heavy oil because that's 4-stroke engine oil, but it won't do it any harm at all. But I have actually took out all the lubrication of this now, so you want to make sure you... just got a bit of lubrication around everything. And just to get in them bearings. This stuff here is duck oil. Brilliant. So now, let us put all this back together. This stuff here, like I say, it's just duck oil, that's all it is. It's like WD-40, but I prefer it to WD-40 because it's a little bit thicker. So, there's the little hammer gone. I had that little hammer here. Get quite fiddly. One clip back in this side. Back in, so now we can tap the gudgeon pin. We can now tap this gudgeon pin back in. Just get these, get this other clip in. There you go, back in. Perfect. Piston back in, put a bit more duck oil on that bearing just to make sure that's all good. There's very little gasket around this cylinder block, very little. Gasket's coming off now with a wire brush, which is good. I'm doing it upside down so I don't want debris to get washed in the engine. Gasket and see how we're doing. our barrel gasket, really, which comes over here. This is going to be a mission. Getting this over the threads is not easy. Ah, these studs are thicker at the top and they go thinner at the bottom. So that'll drop down there now. And then it goes thicker again. These are not so good. In fact, we've even broken the new gasket in the corner, but luckily that's on the outside, so I think once that's home, pretty oh yeah, that'll seal that up. Yep, that's no problem. Right, so our new gasket's on. I'm going to put this back in the vise again. So I'm going to need to nip the rings up with my fingers to get them in. Bit of oil on the finger, rub around the inside of the cylinder. If you want this cylinder nicely lubricated. You never want to put a piston back in a. So that comes this way. Going to, if I can, I'm going to try and have to try and lock this engine. Right, we're going to have to come back for a part two because I've actually got a broken piston ring, which is a shame, but we can't put it back together with a broken piston ring, so I'm going to have to get a piston ring order set, and then we will have to do a part two on the video, because unfortunately one of the rings are broken. And I'm not going to put it together with a broken ring, because there's just no point. It's really false economy. So yeah, I'm afraid we're going to have to call it a day for today, guys. And we will come back for a part two. No doubt, I will get the parts ordered today, and hopefully we can get the video done in the next couple of weeks. So we'll cover him up for now. And yeah, we will be back for a part two very soon. Right, thanks for watching. Sorry this has been a bit long-winded. And bye-bye for now. Cylinder block, very little. Coming off now with a wire brush. Good. I'm doing it upside down, so I don't want debris to get washed in the engine. Gasket and see how we're doing. Right. We want our barrel gasket, really, which comes over here. Over the threads is not easy. Ah, these studs are thicker at the top and they go thinner at the bottom. Start to drop down there now. And then it goes thicker again. These are not good. In fact, we've even broken the new gasket in the corner, but luckily that's on the outside, so I think once that's home, pretty sure. Oh yeah, that'll seal that up. Yeah, that's no problem. Right, so our new gasket's on. I'm going to put this back in the vise again. So I'm going to need to nip. I'm going to need to nip the rings up with my fingers to get them in. Bit of oil on the finger, rub around the inside of the cylinder. If you want this cylinder, you want the cylinder nicely lubricated. You never want to put a piston back in a. So that comes this way. If I can, I'm going to try. I'm going to try and lock this engine. Thank you. Right, we're going to have to come back for a part two because I've actually got a broken piston ring. Which is a shame. But we can't put it back together with a broken piston ring. So I'm going to have to get a piston ring order set. And then we will have to do a part two on the video. Because unfortunately, one of the rings are broken. And I'm not going to put it together with a broken ring, because there's just no point. It's really false economy. So yeah, I'm afraid we're going to have to call it a day for today, guys. And we will come back for a part two. No doubt, I will get the parts ordered today, and hopefully we can get the video done in the next couple of weeks. So we'll cover him up for now. And yeah. We will be back for a part two very soon. Right, thanks for watching. Sorry this has been a bit long-winded. And bye-bye for now.